Hey, all you beautiful people, and welcome to the next to the last day of Techmas. I have had fun sharing tips with you, and I hope you've enjoyed hearing them. I know that Christmas has now officially passed, but Christmas is the season that we all wish would last all year, right? Not the stress, but the meaning of it. And so I want to share a really cool idea for Christmas gifts. My brothers and I are close, which I'm very thankful for, and we grew up with not a lot of money, so I think this make your own gift trend was probably born in us when we were younger, although we didn't always do that for each other younger. But what's so cool is the last several years we've tried to make gifts for each other or do different things. For example, if you watched day two of Techmas, I talked to you about how I made my brother a birthday breakout game. You can go back and watch that one. But over the years, we've made lots of things. I've made the ornaments where you take a photo and stick it inside the clear ornament, and I did those for both brothers and their wives for each year of their relationship. They had one ornament. One year I took Jamie, the brother who made the game I'm about to show you, loves Risk. So I couldn't find a copy of Risk, but I made the game Stratego, and I put his friends' faces on all the different avatars in that game. And then for John Curtis, yes, I'm country, I call him by both names, but for John Curtis, I took Monopoly and replaced every square and every chance card with something about his life. So it's a lot of fun to make a homemade game. If you have not done that, you should try it. And so I want to show you the most recent addition to our homemade gifts. And this is a game that Jamie made for me. Now, I'm a child of the 1980s, and so you're at the end of my game. At the moment, there's no way to restart the game, and so I'm showing you the very end. But Jamie made this game for me, and it was 80s trivia. And when I got to the end, which you're looking at the last page, and I clicked on Claim Your Prize. By the way, Jamie is a developer. That's how he's able to do all this. When I click Claim Your Prize, it took me to an actual scavenger hunt maker that I can use myself. So not only did he give me a one-time game, but he taught me to fish. So now I can create games, and I've already started on that. I have a back in time New Year's scavenger hunt. If you would like to play that game, if you will just comment on this video, then I will be happy to share that link with you. I would love to give you that information. It's a fun New Year's look back at the last decade, okay? So if you'd like to play that game, again, just put your name in the comments, and then I will send you a message with how to get into the game. Sound great? So that's my element of Christmas for today, Christmas after Christmas. And now let's get down to the element of technology that I want to share. So there is a fabulous website. If you've never been there, they tried a few years ago to change the name, and I've noticed that it's still IFTTT, which is what a lot of us called it. But IF is what they tried to change it to. But IFTTT stands for If This, Then That. Okay. So IFTTT.com is something that allows you to automate a lot of your life. And so if you need to know the weather on a certain day, if you need some devices at your house to talk to each other, there's so many things it can do that involve your phone, involve Google Drive, involve Microsoft OneDrive, just all kinds of different things. So today I'm going to show you just a couple of my favorite. They used to be called recipes. Now they're called applets. I'm going to show you a couple of my favorite applets. And then I want to hear in the comments over here or on Twitter, if you want to share this Facebook Live, that would be amazing. But I want to share what applets you have created and how they're helping you automate your life. So let me tell you a story. About three years ago, I was new to my technology position. I had had a Twitter account, but I just thought of it honestly as Facebook statuses. I'm like, what is the point of this? This is what I ate for dinner. I'm a 16-year-old. You know, I just didn't really get the point. I did not realize how powerful Twitter could be. And so when I got on Twitter seriously, was 3 years ago, 2014, and I'm like, I want to make this count for me. So I remember I had like maybe 30 followers. I remember celebrating when I got to my 100th follower. I sent the person something of her choice. I want to shout out to Judy Haggerty. She wanted McDonald's fries, and so I made that happen for her when she was my 100th follower. Now I have, let's look over there, y'all. I'm curious now, but I have 1,600-something followers, I think, in just 3 years. That may be a really slow rate of growth. Oh, 1601, how exciting. That may be a really slow rate of growth or really low number for some of you. But for me, that was very exciting to go from 30 to 1600 in about 3 years. So I'm going to teach you a trick. One of the applets on IFTTT that I love involves Twitter. So let me show you how it works. You go to search. You type in a product that you would like automations for. They're called applets again. So I'm going to search for Twitter. And I'm actually going to add this. I'm going to say Twitter list. I'm going to see if I can find it that way. Okay. So it makes me click the service first, okay? And I have to kind of look. Let me see if I can find it. And y'all, when I tried to click the more button earlier, it was not working. So I think something's up today because there are definitely more. So let me tell you what happens. I have an applet call that says, it says I don't have any applets. Wonderful. Okay, I'm gonna sign out into my other account. No, I'm not. Okay, so what this applet does is it every time that you that somebody on Twitter searches for a certain hashtag. So for example, you know on Twitter, you can do hashtag gamification. I talked about that in my video about 2 days ago as well. And so my applet, what it would do is every time someone searched for gamification, it would add them automatically to a list of mine. So if I go back to my home, okay, and I go to my profile, and I go to my lists, for example, I have a list called gamification tweeters. I did not create any of that, okay? What I did was I went on IFTTT, I connected Twitter, and I said, okay, anytime somebody searches for this particular hashtag, add them to my list. Now, because my list has gotten so big, you can't see it over here. I can click right here, and this is anybody who searched for gamification, I add them to a list. Now, what would be the point of that? The point of that is that they would see that I had added them to a list and they're like, oh my gosh, I should follow her, okay? And it was a quick way to get some more people in my professional learning network. I didn't search for a spammy thing. I really am interested in gamification and I really do tweet about that. So that would be my one piece of advice. Pick something you're actually interested in and that you add value to the stream for. Another hashtag that I search a lot is MIE expert. I am a Microsoft Innovative Educator expert. Again, I talked about that in my badging video a couple days ago. And so another applet I had was anytime somebody searches for this or adds this to a tweet, add them to my list, okay? So that's one of the cool ways that you can use IFTTT is to automate Twitter followers because you're adding them to a list and then they're gonna want to follow you, okay? Another way that I use it a lot, and I don't want to show you this because it's going to give personal information of mine, but let me show you the tool at least. I have a Google Drive that I use personally. So I'm going to go to Drive. Okay, here's Google Drive. And we'll see if this one's going to show. Again, their more button is broken on the day I want to show you this. But there, yeah, it's not going to show. We'll try to click the more button. I don't think it's going to work. Okay. So we'll say connect and we'll see if that'll work. You know what? It's going to show you my Google information. So never mind. Go back. Okay. So here are the applets that I'm using that involve Google Drive. I have one that says if I put hashtag mile on a text that I send to a certain number, which is IFTTT's number, it's going to add mileage to a spreadsheet. So I am in a job where I track mileage and report that every month. And so instead of me having to get out a little notebook, write down my mileage, anytime I'm in the car heading from one school to another, I text myself on this number. I have it saved in my phone as mileage, but IFTTT will actually give you a number. And so when I text that number, if I include hashtag mile, it knows that that needs to go on my mileage spreadsheet. So then at the end of the month, all I have to do is copy all those mileage sheets, tweak a little bit, and then it does my totals for me. Isn't that amazing? And I don't have to pay for any product. IFTTT is free. If you're a female and there are certain things you need to track every month, if you get my drift, that's another way that you could use this. If you use the hashtag, whatever is significant to you, I'm trying to be classy here, then you can also track yourself that way if you need to know some medical information, okay? So grow your Twitter following, track important data just by going on here, clicking search, picking a tool. I'm going to show you one more before we get off this call. And OneNote is a huge favorite tool of mine. And so let's just look at some of the things OneNote can do. So again, I went to search, I typed OneNote, okay? You have to connect it with your account, but I don't want to show you guys my personal account information. So that's why I'm not doing that right now. But when you scroll down below here, are all the things you can do. Okay, let's say, oh, when OneNote puts a new something on IFTTT, they can send you an email to let you know. Or, when you create something on your iOS, so your Apple calendar, it'll create a new page in OneNote. It'll tell you what it works with this little icon down here. And if you hover over it, you can see what it's connected to. Okay, this one I know is connected to Gmail. Okay, I don't know what Pocket is. Okay, anytime you take a photo on or a screenshot on your iPhone, it'll send it to OneNote. So maybe that's something important to you. Maybe you want to copy your tasks and reminders to OneNote. I think that could be really important because I use OneNote a lot for to-do lists because it's got amazing little checkboxes. So just, again, pick a favorite tool, pick an applet, get them connected, and then you're going to automate your life. So here's what I want you to do. Here's your call to action for this video. I want you to share with me if you would like to be added to the game. I would like you to put that in the comments over there, and I will send you a message with that information. And if you go to IFTTT.com, sign up, tell me what it's doing that's changing your life. Let me show you one more fun one. I said one more, but this is so fun, y'all. So another one you can do, I don't know about you, but I don't usually dress for the weather. And if you have children, it makes you look like a really neglectful parent if you forget to dress them for the weather. So if you type in weather, you can come down below and you have a thing that says, okay, I want to add today's weather report to my calendar every day, or I want to receive an email if there's going to be rain in my area tomorrow, or I want to be texted the weather every morning, or, you know, you just keep on going. You can get a message that says rain today, don't forget an umbrella, whatever it is. So you've got all this information that you can get sent automatically to you. Again, IFTTT, it is a game changer. Hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you got something out of it, but I want to hear about it, y'all. Don't leave me hanging out here in live land. Let me know what you got out of it. Take care.